I began to see the markers as portraits. Like, I saw them as portraits between the living and the dead. So if you took the time to put this material, this tree is not where somebody is buried. But what happens is when people go to visit a saint or go to visit their relatives, there are certain natural, not objects, but things, whether it's sometimes a water hole, sometimes a tree, that there's a history of the site that a miracle has occurred here at some point. So people believe that if they come here and pray, that something will be healed. And there's actually evidence, like they say of prayer, that if a whole community prays for someone, the person, there's been evidence that the person actually often gets better. So, I mean, it's not about religion as much as it is faith. The idea of faith, of believing in something, whatever that is. So I began to see the idea of someone going and tying something, even on the tree, as a portrait of that person, of a portrait of faith, of a portrait of believing. So if I photographed it the way landscape photography usually is photographed, you would just see this big space, right, with these things in it, but you wouldn't have that experience of intimacy. So I really wanted to have the experience of intimacy. And if you have studied photography, you learn, one of the basic things you learn is if you do portraiture, you use like a certain kind of lens, which is usually a long lens, right? Longer than a 50 millimeter, which is a long lens. And the one thing that you must have in focus, if there's a rule that you can break, is the person's eyes. The nose can be out of focus, the ears can be out of focus, but the eyes should always be in focus. So there was something I always picked when I was photographing that I knew had to be in focus. They were the eyes in. So they were part of the intimacy. So, I mean, every now and then I'll photograph a landscape with a landscape, which is usually a wide angle lens, the depth of field, everything is sharp. But often I would try and photograph the landscape the way that you would photograph a portrait.
What are the eyes of this one?
For me, it was the material that we're tying on the end.
We talked a lot about how our eyes were drawn exactly there and how we felt like it was a mix, a portrait of the person who had gone, but also a portrait of the people who had come.
So you said exactly what I was hoping to get across.